Hi guys, let's look into calculating log for NEET and JEE main. I'm going to be showing you pretty simple way of doing it. You can do a lot of approximation, meaning we don't have to know the real values. Here's a list of log values that you are supposed to know, log 1 through log 10. Crudely remember them. If you forget it, I'll show you how to actually calculate them by yourself. Only few things you have to remember. Before we go in, I want to clarify a few things when it comes to log. When you do a log of a number, for example, let's take log 4, I've approximated it to 0.60. Now what you need to know is, when you do a log, the number before the decimal, okay, in our case, like here it is 0, here it is 1, these are called characteristic, and the numbers after the decimal are called mantissa. Doesn't really matter if you remember the names. For both JEE, main and NEET, you don't need to remember the names, but one thing you want to know is the significant figures. When you do log of any number, the corresponding number that you get after the log, the digits after the decimal point is the significant figure. For example, log 6, this is 0.78, only two significant figures. Maybe better example is log 10. Normally when you look at this number, you would say three significant figures, but the number before you never take, this is characteristic. Maybe I can explain this with a better example as we go along. Well, let's look into how we can calculate or remember log values. The least minimum you have to remember is these values. These are extremely simple. Log values are from log 1 through infinity. Log 1 is 0, log infinity is infinity. You cannot take a log of a number that is less than 0. Log of a number from between 0 and 1 is going to be negative value. Log 1 is 0, anything greater than log 1 is positive value. But let's assume that you remember all these, then how can we get the other values approximately? Now we can look into log 4. Log 4 is nothing but log of 2 squared, which is 2 log 2. That's going to be 2 times log 2 is 0.3. So that is 0.6. So we can get that as 0.6. Similarly, log 8 is log of 2 to the power 3, that is 3 log 2, that is going to be 3 times 0.3 is 0.9. Alright, now that I have this, I can fill the remaining approximately. Right in between, so it's not actually exactly average, it turns out to be so here. Now we can do this one. This is critical. If you can remember 0.48, it is good. If not, something in between, 0.45. Now log 6 is log of 2 times 3. Log of A times B is log A plus log B. That is going to be 0.30 plus 0.45. That's going to be 0.75. Approximately. Now log 5 is somewhere in between, you can put this, and this is somewhere in between, you can put it as 0.80 or 85. Now this is how you can remember the values, just these three alone. Particularly log 2 is a number that keeps coming in equilibrium. If you can remember this, you can do all these values. These are much simpler way of doing it. Here are the basic rules of logarithm that you have to know. Here I have chosen a base A. Most of the time the base is 10 for you guys. Usually LOG is reserved for 10, but you can have log base of anything. As long as the base and the corresponding number is same, the log of that value is going to be 1. Meaning log of 2, if the log base is 2, the value is 1. Log of e to the power e right here is 1. So log of anything with the corresponding base is 1, that you want to know. And regardless of the base that you take, 1 is assigned as 0. So these are a couple of things you want to know. Now here log of AB or MN is log M plus log N. This you will see a lot of time in EKM and Nernst equation. Log of M to the power P, P goes to the front, P log M. Most of the time you ignore the A because it's usually 10 for you guys. Log of AB is log A plus log B. Log of A by B is log A minus log B. And log of 1 by n, it comes in Nernst equation as well, most of the time with your hydrogen electrode, H plus could be in the bottom. 1 by n, you can do two ways. Log of m by n is log m minus log n. Log 1 is 0, so 0 minus log n is minus log n. So log of 1 by anything is minus log of that particular number. Now this is also important. Anytime you have a number and you want to get rid of the log term, so basically the corresponding number equals the base to the power n. So normally you guys are going to do 10 base. Log of x to the base 10 equals y, x equals 10 to the power y. Similarly, log of 10 base x equals, let's say, minus y, x equals 10 to the power minus y. This is important because this comes in equilibrium with weak acids and weak bases. This is a way to cancel log. This actually doesn't come for you much, but basically if you look at it, let's make all the a's as 10. 10 log 10 to the power m is m. 10 and log, the base and the 10 will cancel out. As I told you, log of 0 cannot exist. You have a value of somewhere greater than 0 all the way till little less than infinity. Log a, negative cannot exist. 0 cannot exist, negative also cannot exist. Now if log of two terms is equal, then the numbers must be equal. This is straightforward. This is how to convert one base log to another base. For example, I have base A. I can convert it to base C by doing this formula. This also is not that important, good to know, but it has never come in NEET JEE. So it's okay. Now again, couple of things that we want to know. When the value is greater than 0 all the way to 1, log of that number is going to be, this is 0, this is going to be negative. So log of any number that is between 0 and 1 is negative. Any number that is between 1 through infinity is positive. Log of any number that is 1 is 0. You want to remember this. Now here I've shown you a couple of common logarithms that we use. Most commonly we use common logarithm of base 10. So what I just wrote, x would be 10 to the power y. If this is minus y, x would be 10 to the power minus y. Natural logarithm or ln, this comes in kinetics. And your Arrhenius equation, you can see this, comes in kinetics. Basically it is to the base e. E is a number that is 2.7. You don't need to remember the full number, 2.7, but just remember e, that is more than enough. Now how do you convert one to the another? So we can convert ln to log by multiplying by 2.303. For example, ln of x equals 2.303 log of x. That's all. Now that we have understood log, let's look into the more complicated one, calculating anti-log. Particularly, you will have this in your equilibrium. We have established this. This is straightforward. Now, how can we calculate? I'm going to be calculating and showing you how to do this here and actually compare it to the actual value. How you want to do it is pretty simple. For positive numbers right here, positive numbers, we have log of x equals 7.3. That tells you x equals 10 to the power 7.3, that is 10 to the power 7 plus 10 to the power 0.3. Correct? So 10 to the power AB is 10 power A times 10 power B. Now this is pretty simple. What we can do is we can keep the 10 to the power 7 as it is. 10 to the power 0.3. Log of which number is 0.3? Log of 2 is 0.3010. So this is going to be, just put this number here, 2. That's it. We can do one more example, you will understand. Log x equals 7.67. x equals 10 to the power 7.67. That equals 10 to the power 7 plus 10 to the power 0.67. Now, if you go back to our log table, we want 0.67. If you have not memorized it already, let's just look at it. We have 10 to the power 0.67. I have 0.67 somewhere here between 4 and 5. So what I can do here, I can write it as this number as maybe 4.5 times 10 power 7. Let's write those values that we got. Here we got 2 times 10 to the power 7. Here roughly 4.5 times 10 to the power 7. Next, let's do 10 to the power 2.42. Log x equals 2.42. X equals 10 to the power 2.42. That equals 10 to the power 2 plus 10 to the power 0.4. 10 power 0.42. We know log 2 is 0.3. Log 4 is 0.6. We decided log 3 is 0.45. This is something less than 0.45. You can take whichever number you want. Something little less than 3. So I can make it as, let's say, 2.8 times 10 to the power 2. 2.8 times 10 to the power 2. This is how you do for a positive number. Positive number is very simple. 10 to the power of this number is basically split it into 2. Before the decimal and after the decimal, straightforward. Now we have to do a little bit of trick for negative numbers. What do you want for negative numbers? We want to make sure, let's take this one, log of x equals minus 12.71. That tells you x equals 10 to the power minus 12.71. We cannot do log of minus 12 times log of minus 0.71 because we don't know the negative values here. Which log gives you negative value? Instead, what we can do is a shortcut. We are going to do minus 12.71 minus what number, if you add decimal number, that it will make it a round number. It is going to be 0.29. That will make it minus 13. And I do. So minus and plus cancels out. So this is what I have. So this gives me 10 to the power minus 13 plus 10 to the power 0.29. Correct? 10 to the power 0.29 or 10 to the power 0.3 is basically from log 2, right? So this is going to be 2 times 10 to the power minus 13. Little less than 2. So we can write it as 1.9 times 10 power minus 13. So we forgot to write down this number. So this we wrote it as something like 2 times 10 power minus, no, positive 7. This we wrote it as 4.5 times 10 power 7. And this we wrote it as 2.8 times 10 power 2. Alright, last one. One more example, log of x equals minus 5.08. So imagine that, let's say this is what is given. You have to calculate. Usually pH to H plus conversion, all those you can see. Now x equals 10 to the power minus 5.08. That equals 10 to the power minus 5.08 minus 0.92 plus 0.92. That equals 10 power minus 6 plus 10 power 0.92. If you look at the table from before, 0.9 is log 8. 0.95 is log 9, so it's right in between. So I can take it something as 8.5 times 10 power minus 6. So this is what we got based on our calculations. Now let's see whether how close are we to the actual value. That's pretty right on. This is good enough. This is also good enough. That's pretty good for a negative value and 8.32. So this is how you calculate anti-log, particularly in equilibrium, to calculate the concentration of H plus when pH is given. And this, even this amount of approximation, you can go even much further because the numbers are always far away in NEET, particularly more so than JEE mains. But even this approximation is more than enough for JEE mains. Again, this will be easier. What you can do? Take arbitrary numbers, use your calculators, calculate the value and do this method and see, particularly the negative one, that is what you want. Right? Practice guys, you'll be fine. And I have posted this as a worksheet below the description link.